Hello, welcome to Fleischer's Universe.
That was real time. This is Fleischer's Universe. We have a very, very, very exciting show tonight. Mr. Tyler Shields is here, ladies and gentlemen. Extraordinary photographer with visionary skills for pixel patterns and thrills of lanterns that linger in your mind. You got Find a Monkey. You got Who's Shoes. I'm playing a game with the cameraman, but he don't know where I'm gonna go. Before you were born, this time, and very, very, very differently, we have a mystery patent. A celebrity patent attached to it. It's never been done. We are live! Did anybody misunderstand me when I said we're live?
Skills. I still really don't, but I have a show, so hey, I'm gonna take my guitar and put it over here. That's the place to put it. I'm going to preset the architecture for the next segmentation so that I'm ready to control things. And please notice the dodecahedron in the background. The stars are sparkling slightly. And behold, who sits in the red chair upon this day?
It is I.
It is I. It is I, and I am
pleasure.
So grateful to meet this man because I know his work before I knew him. This is Tyler Shields, everybody.
Hello.
Please say hello. Hello, Tyler.
Where does that come from?
It comes from the center of the old place.
It's just space dust floating around.
Everything's floating around, my brother.
We're all space dust.
We are stardust.
That's right.
And by that, are we close enough to each other? I feel there's a distance. That's good.
You want to be closer.
Yeah.
Is that good?
We actually moved you apart so we could get singles tonight, Charles.
Singles?
Yeah, it would be a first for us.
Singles. We, but I need proximity. You get singles. I'm over a camera, not a human.
Right.
Because I want to address what you said before we get to the thing. Because
yeah.
You said we're space dust and stardust.
Right.
And in reality, we, the atoms in our bodies, were created in stars.
Yeah.
That's pretty heavy.
It is.
And life on Earth comes from the sun, mm-hmm. which is a star, where we eat light.
We just eat light. We're just floating through space, and we think we're in a special place, but we're all just dust, fragments of dust.
We think we're in a special place, but we're just fragments of dust. We say we shouldn't do it, and yet we know that we must. We're particles of light. We eat light. We use light. We see light. You are light upon the fractal fan.
I've peed light since I've been here 3 times.
I noticed that there was a puddle of light
yeah.
in the restroom.
Sorry
and
about
I
that.
I thought to myself, only a photographer could piss light.
Yeah.
As they often said, the F stops here. And focus backwards is suck off.
That's right.
That is right, and you piss light. I'm happy about that. Hey,
focus backwards is suck. Oh, it is suck off.
I've been
That's
wondering.
Brad Wyman, ladies and gentlemen, the producer of this extraordinary thing. And these are FU cups. And I toast, I'm not even looking to see which camera's on.
Oh, thank you.
But to you, sir.
Thank you.
FU, and I say that in the best sense.
I feel like I just met my dad for the first time.
I feel like I just met my grandfather.
Yes.
You know, physical appearance can be an illusion. Souls are older than the molds that hold them.
That's true. I think I met you once before.
Before then or before now?
I think it was 512 years ago. You were walking through a place in Paris.
Yes.
You had just robbed that woman who I think you had slept with.
I did not rob her. I took my stuff back.
Okay.
That whore had taken all of my stuff. The same shit. 500 years changes nothing. You would think a few reincarnations, we could pop back to something. Now, T.S., anybody ever call you T.S.?
You call me anything you like.
Well, I shan't, but
okay.
I might.
T.S., go.
But T.S., like T.S. Eliot. I begin my shows by showing a little card which tells us the date and also a palindrome, the same backwards and forwards. And as you can see, the palindrome for show number 30 is Eva, Can I Stab Bats in a Cave? And
yes.
I tried to pick one that would be appropriate to your visual sensibility.
Beautiful.
And I could even see that being a theme for one of your photo shoots.
Eva stabbing
Or perhaps
bats
someone
in
asking
a cave.
Eva if they can
stab
bats
yeah,
in a
yeah.
cave. Because it is a question.
Right.
It's the same backwards and forwards.
Right.
And there's yet to be, to my knowledge, a photographer who has addressed the palindromic conundrum of light duality, you know, particle wave.
Right.
Now, today, the date of today is a prime number.
Yep.
Are you mathematically inclined?
I can do some math, yes.
Yeah, I could never do math.
Okay.
Until I had a calculator.
Right.
Because it was laborious, but the calculator freed me to just wander and then explore. And today, 81611, prime number.
Amazing.
Yo, prime.
I'm ready for that shit.
Ready, and prime numbers are prime, and the mathematical system I've discovered called Mollied's is based on prime number 37 and its reciprocal 27.
Everything equals 37?
Well, if you have the skills,
right.
you can make everything equal anything.
Of course.
But do you have a favorite number, Tyler Shields?
Ooh, 92.
92, is that random or just making that up?
No, that's actually my favorite number.
Really? That's interesting for lots of reasons.
Yeah.
And why, were you born in 29?
No, I was born in
September
82.
82,
yeah.
So you added a factor of 10, which is the 10 fingers, right?
Mm-hmm.
And since, do you ever take pictures ambidextrously?
I do, I'm very ambidextrous.
Seriously?
Yeah.
You actually depress the shutter with either hand?
Yeah, they don't make the cameras you know, left-hand friendly.
They don't make left-hand cameras.
No. But a lot of the times when I hang out of buildings or things like that, I will support myself by holding on to something with the right hand and then take the picture with the left hand.
Yes.
But that's only when I'm upside down or in some sort of a weird situation.
When I hang out in buildings, I get support for my socks.
Good.
By suspending my suspenders.
Do you put your socks on left foot or right foot first?
It depends on the day, the moment, the foot, how smelly a foot may or may not be.
Do the socks always match?
Always match.
Always
and
match.
And indeed,
yeah, that's fantastic.
Not only match, but you know how we're conditioned.
Right.
One day I put on a sock,
mm-hmm.
and there was a little hole in it.
Okay.
On that very day, I was driving down the street, and a car swerved, barely missing me, and I smashed into the curb.
Whoa.
So
that sock had to go.
I was conditioned. Well, not on the sock, but I will never put on a sock with a hole in it again. Do you find that you are a victim of that kind of hot stove syndrome?
No. I used to be when I was a kid.
You're still a child.
And then I said, you know what? I'm not gonna live by those rules anymore. In fact, I'm not gonna live by any rules. If the sock's got a hole in it, fuck that sock.
Well, fuck that sock, but if you ever had anything happen, and if a sock has a hole in it, you fuck that sock. That's another kind of sock.
I did have something like this happen. I was on an airplane, and it was a similar type situation. Super weird. I probably shouldn't tell this story.
You definitely should.
But it's all right. No one's watching.
No, you definitely should tell it.
I put my underwear on backwards one day.
Really?
And I was like, what
Only
the
one day?
I was like, what the fuck? How did my underwear get
was
on backwards?
An accident?
Total accident. I was on my way to Amsterdam.
Well, that explains it.
I was like,
capital of anal sex.
I was like, okay. I got to the airport.
Besides Greece.
Greece is a rough place.
So is Amsterdam and have your underwear on backwards.
So I got to I put my underwear on right. I got to the airport and I went to check in for my flight and they were like, oh, your plane blew up. And I was like, huh? And my plane was on the tarmac, literally on fire. This is when I was a kid.
That's amazing. And have you worn backwards underwear change?
Never.
So indeed.
But that plane almost crashed when I finally got on the plane. Got hit by lightning, hooked to the right, all the bags fell out. Hooked to the left, all the bags from the other side fell out. Everyone except for me that was in my row was unconscious.
But you remained alert because your underpants was on backwards.
No, I remained alert because I sat in the middle seat that no one else wanted to take.
But your
and I could
backwards.
Do that because my underwear were on right and my ass was comfortable enough to sit there for 12 hours.
I like that. Well, you know the ass associates and assimilates to the seat upon which it sits because of the crack in the ass.
That's right.
If your ass were not cracked, you would not be able to successfully sit.
That's true.
And
anything I took in would just stay in me, and that would be horrible. I'd have a lot of In-N-Out burgers in there.
Well, hence the name In-N-Out.
Right. It's shit's got to go in, but it's got to go out.
Well, that's the duality speaking.
Right.
Now, I'm always fascinated by anybody with talent.
Okay.
Because it just, it speaks to another level of existence. It speaks to going beyond the present, whereby your work can live on and inspire people for a long time.
Amazing.
So, and visual arts, I've always been just amazed by. Salvador Dali, when I first saw his work, I want to try that.
Right.
So I'm just curious as to the moment when, or series of moments, when you realized that you had a gift for creating visual literature.
Yeah. Thank you, by the way.
You're welcome, by the war.
By the way. It wasn't, I think it was other people, actually. I started getting emails from people. I knew that photographs were interesting, and I knew that you could make interesting photographs, but I don't think I even grasped how much that things like that could affect people. And it started getting 100 emails a week. That turned into 1,000, turned into 10,000. And some people would write me these, you know, super long, in-depth, you know, messages or emails about how this one specific image changed their life. And at first I was like, oh, that's gotta be, you know, like, it can't really. But then I realized it actually, something can affect somebody that much to where, you know, people were writing me like, I was in law school and I dropped out because fuck that, I want to do this. And not that I encourage them to do that, but, you know, law school sounds terrible.
I do encourage you.
Yeah.
To drop out and drop on, drop in, drop anywhere.
I mean, for me, I've never been a fan of school. You know, I have no problem with people that go to school, but I think that the best school is life. And I think the only professor that matters is success or whatever you want to do and doing it well.
What you profess, you address, even if the address is wrong. Now, I just want to dial that chronometer back.
Let's go back.
Okay, so you were, this is after you've already found that you love this little box with the shutter.
Right.
And silver oxide. And
you want to know how I started it all?
I'm just curious. I want to know what your first camera was.
Okay, so I didn't own a camera. I stole one from my roommate, who was a photographer.
You stole a camera?
I did.
How old were you?
19.
Charlie's mic. 19.
Yeah.
He was only 19 when he stole his first camera. That's a Steely Dan song, I think.
I hope my old roommate is watching this.
What kind of camera was it?
It's a Canon. So basically what happened was this. I was living with a girl and another fellow, and he was a photographer. He'd been a photographer for about 15 years. But he'd never really done anything with it. He just kind of would take pictures of random stuff. That cheating, lying bitch just, broke my heart in two. Not really. But she did cheat on me. So I threw all of her stuff out. And I was like, I want to remember this moment. I need to take a picture of it. Mm. So I went and took his camera. And there was only one picture left on his camera.
That's good.
I took that picture. And that picture is what started my whole career.
And it was color?
Yeah.
And you remember the speed of the film?
400. 400. Yeah. 400. I shot a 30.
That's pretty fast.
30 stops.
Film, yeah.
And I lit it using an IKEA lamp that I also stole from my neighbor.
Well, we have
thievery.
An interesting thing.
Thievery just started it all.
Well, it's interesting you should say that, because right now what we're going to do is play a little game called the Dirty Dozen.
Amazing.
And what's really amazing is this is going to deal with people who have crept to the other side of the law.
Right.
Now, we're going to see on the screen 12 different people. Each of these perpetrators has done an act. Now, I'm going to tell you an act that they have done, and you're going to see if you can pick who it is.
Okay.
All right, you ready for this?
Yes.
Don't forget the music, Charles.
I won't forget, the music, but I'll tell you one thing. The music will never forget you, Brad.
Just like when you did the whole thing.
You gotta have it all. Brad. You gotta have it all.
I love Brad.
Brad Wyman.
Brad
That's
Wyman.
Why we're all here. I have pictures of Brad, but I can't talk about
Sometimes
Brad.
In my dreams, Brad appears on a horse with a shotgun.
If you only knew how synchronistic that was.
I know that you feel that for me.
Let me just tell you right now.
Yeah.
Our first perpetrator.
Yes.
Is from Kentucky.
Rough place. Great chicken.
He faces cruelty to animal charges because he had sex with a horse.
Oh, a horse fucker?
But Brad wasn't on the horse, fortunately for the horse. Now, I just will point out that it's quite interesting that you mentioned Brad Wyman on a horse and the first crime.
Is it? Or did I know that was going to happen?
Of course you knew. There is nothing that has not been known.
We're all space dust!
Of Tyler Shields.
All right, which one of these people is a horse fucker? Is that what I'm going
question.
For?
Which is the horse fucker?
Okay, well, it's definitely not that woman, man, up there in the corner.
You never know. Maybe. This is flying for
the strap-ons count for horse fucking?
We do not limit the phallus to any device.
Hmm. All right.
You have 5 seconds to pick the horse fucker.
See, you want to go number 9. I'm going to go number 7.
Number 7. Is not the horse fucker.
God damn it.
Everyone, I'm gonna get.
Audience says 9. SRV229.
Everyone says 9.
Number 9. Number 9 we had last week. Number 9, interestingly enough, is a dog fucker.
See, I wouldn't have got horse from number 9, but people immediately, you see a beard and you think horse.
Well, you know, so
I see that guy.
A horse, of course.
I would have pegged him for maybe like a rapist.
I'm gonna give you another shot.
Okay, good.
Another shot at this one, because I think, and since this is a 28-year-old person, that's going to give you some clues.
Why didn't I think that it was number 5? He looks like a horse. He just wants to be with his own kind.
That is a very good call.
Why didn't I think that?
He looks kind of like Jeff Goldblum after eating horse tranquilizers and sleeping at
in a hyperbaric chamber.
Neil Pinel's house. Okay, I'm going to, number 5, I'm going to tell you what I'm doing. I'm going to give it to you. We now announce the horse fucker from McCracken County is 28-year-old Nathan Johnson. Number 2!
Damn it.
Number 2.
Glasses.
You cannot judge a man by glasses. Brad says, glasses, I put on my glasses. What? Transition, motherfucker!
Where did it all go wrong for him?
I would say he was watching Mr. Ed one day and his father like whacked him upside the head. Hmm. Maybe he's lonely. Maybe he just, you know, the play Equus?
Hmm.
You know, Equus, or he had an equine wine time. Hmm. He was saddled with guilt.
Maybe his father was a horse mover.
Saddled with guilt.
He is so quick. There's never been a lag that he can't catch up to.
No.
He's lagging, but not a pony. All right, well, good because we have established. I'm going to go to yet another one of our infamous group here. And we can, let's show them all here. Now, this next individual, I won't say what sex, but he was trying to cash a check.
Okay.
And they were a little suspicious because it was from a church. And the church's telephone number had been crossed out on the check. And, of course, he had stolen the money from a church's youth group.
Can you tell me where?
Where it was? That's too much of a
clue. Okay, because number 7 is looking pretty church rapey to me.
They're all regional.
Yeah.
Okay, let's just...
It's got to be 6 or 7.
You say 6 or 7?
Yeah.
Unity One says 12. Icon says number 3. Rex Sykes says Glancy Mike says 1.
I'll give you a clue. He has a tattoo on his head. And something can be read, but something is pixelated and it's not there.
Who would let that guy in a church?
Number 3, he stole the shit.
Seriously.
Hey, you know.
Who tattoos a blurry tattoo and then you next to it? That's crazy.
It's what all the forgers do. Okay, because look what I've done for you. I've cleared it up.
Oh, thank you.
They tried to obliterate that on some sites because they don't want children's word on his forehead.
Why would he do that?
I would say fucking horses was already taken.
Everybody just wants attention. Brad, if you appear in my dream tonight with that tattoo on your forehead.
Yeah. Oh, tutu.
I'm still on that the
way. Had a Freudian slip.
If you appear in that tutu.
With a tutu and a tattoo.
And a shotgun.
With the tutu and a tattoo and a Raymond bar, he had a little funk in his monkey fur.
Would you photograph me like that, Tyler?
I mean, in a New York minute.
I've always wondered about New York. It's a quicker minute or a slow minute, because it depends where in the city, isn't it?
That's true.
Like New York, so New York minute. It's supposed to be fast, right?
Right.
But what if you're in like, you know, you're in the Bronx and you're here from another place. Or someone's like, hey, give me your money. And you got a knife on you. Boy, that New York minute seemed like an hour.
That's true.
So relative.
You know, cabbies like to rob you in New York.
Like to.
They like to do that. They love that.
Have you ever heard the phrase, big as a minute?
Big as a minute? No.
I'd never heard it either.
Who told you that?
My mother.
Really?
Yes, sir.
When?
Just over the weekend.
Okay.
I was big, visiting.
Is it your big as a minute, or is it?
Referring to one who is diminutive of size, who is petite.
Ah, big as a minute.
Big as a minute.
All right.
It's kind of quaint.
Sharp as a dime, maybe?
Sharp as a dime, sharp as a tack. Minty as a tic-tac. Flowery as a fleur-de-loup. Papalingo. All right, so that's that guy. And obviously the fact that the check had been crossed out and he had fuck you written on his head.
Yeah, that may be.
You know, just a tip for anybody out there. Yeah. Where the camera? We have no signals. I'll just try and find it. Seems like it might be that one. That one, good to know. Any forgers out there, people that are planning any kind of currency?
Don't write fuck you on your head.
Don't write fuck you on your head. And if you do, write it blurry.
And if you do, don't try to cash a check.
Look at that, we're both profiling.
Or,
like.
Or anything.
We could do the interview like Fellini like. Yeah. Hey. You're not the spaceman. I remember when you were
I was told before I came here that I would be able to float in space.
By whom?
Who came to me on a horse.
In your dream.
In my dream. Was it a dream?
Tyler, listen to me.
I'm listening.
There are worlds beyond worlds. There are moments that can never be recreated. This moment was manufactured before there was.
We have found the life within the life. I am no longer here. As it is Tyler's god, find the mission and bleed it.
Which one of these guys is my dad?
All of them, Tyler.
Damn it.
Not
no, you're
once.
My fucking dad.
I was, but I had to retire because your mother kept giving me heart attacks.
Bitch.
There's all right, let's a lot go to of another. People that were in the chat room, Charles, that want to know if it's okay to tattoo the F-U on your forehead.
Yes.
I would say, even though it does speak to the show, I would say hold off on the head.
Right.
Just write it on a poster.
Wait, Brad, have you seen that picture where we wrote love on the girl's hand?
No.
So I did this picture where I wrote love on a hand, and a girl showed up at my house and was like, look. And she tattooed it on her hand in red, exactly how we wrote it.
Read it.
Mm-hmm. Read it. She tattooed it, but she tattooed it in reverse so that when she put it in a mirror, it would be straight.
Well, there was this woman who
that's a lot.
Did a, that's she a lot. Tried to create a crime of racism, and you could tell
not cool.
that she wrote it on her head in a mirror because it was written backwards. Once again, at least that guy, it was written correctly,
right.
Which means he probably didn't do it himself.
That guy knows how to party.
He did.
I mean, anywhere that guy goes, he's just offending people.
Or
except for when he goes to the KKK rallies, then he's awesome.
Wow, you know, I gotta tell you something. You are so in tune with so many things going on here. You are, and this speaks to the imagery that you create, because I think that artists are kind of antennas. Mm-hmm. Musicians, they receive stuff from other places, and to be a visual artist, you just, you know, oh, today I'm going to have a Darth Vader and a hot chick. I'm going to have Superman and Batman with Catwoman. Where do those images come from? They just come from your head and float right in. So I want to go to another one because I like doing this, because I like to see your sensitivity. All right, there's a guy. Yeah, let's see the
music, Charles. Music, Charles. I'm sorry.
Say, well, music's coming up. Yeah. Coming up. You know, it's like I need assistance. It's like music. Well, they give me hire a fucking band. Christ, they want some fucking music.
I get chills when you do it this way.
If it's your music, well, maybe if I had an assistant, so I wouldn't have to write every 9-14 different places. This next young man pretended to be autistic and have the mind of a child. He drank baby formula and used a pacifier and hired women to change his diapers. Is it one of the 12 up here? The answer is yes. Can you tell me who is the man who is going to face 6 years in prison for pretending he was retarded so he could get babysitters to play with his poo?
Oh my God, that's fantastic. Brad, what do they think in the chat?
We've got 5 and 6, basically, across the board.
See, it would kind of be awesome if it was number 11, but that's just asking too much, you know?
Well, just so you know, number one is...
Is that a man?
It was a man.
Okay.
Very perceptive.
Yeah.
And number one went into a bar telling women that he was a doctor that could perform breast exams.
Right.
And was successful until someone questioned their status and then found out that the doctor...
I'm the breast exam man lady.
I'm the breast exam. All right, let's go to let's go to number 7.
It's number 7?
Yeah, the Neil Patrick Harris on Belladonna.
That's it?
That's the baby poo-boo guy. That's him. That's Richardson. That's the guy.
You.
Mark what? Anthony Richardson, the second. How distinguished.
Mar.
And why do you think they always have 3 names for Lee Harvey Oswald, you know, the criminal?
I think a lot of it has to do with when you get your name, you're kind of predetermined for what you're going to do. Anderson Cooper?
Yeah.
That guy only had one choice in life.
CNN.
Yeah, that's
but what
it.
About 60 Minutes?
Nope.
His eyes are so blue.
Nope. CNN. He's
but he's
done.
On 60 Minutes.
Well, you know what? We all fade from glory eventually.
Jeez, I never thought of it like that, Tyler.
I'm just saying.
Wow, you said it well.
Thank you, sir.
I think partially the reason they do it is because for people that have the same first and last
name. Of course.
Have you ever met another Tyler Shields?
I have not.
There's got to be a lot, though.
There's got to be, yeah.
So wouldn't it, or just you ever have a best friend named Tyler?
No.
Nor did I have one named Charles, because it would be conflicting. Imagine if all your friends were your name, and you're in a room and say, hey, Tyler, and everybody turns around.
Yeah, it'd be no good.
It's nuts.
I laid in a bed with a girl named Tyler once.
How long did you lay?
It was awkward. 4 hours.
Did you Tyler?
I did. I tiled her.
Did she smile when you tiled her?
She cried for help.
Crocodile tears?
Yeah, she crocodile tears. No, it was odd, though.
Odd, though?
It was odd.
But you broke even.
I knew a couple, and they both were named Ashley. And they were together for like a year.
That can work.
And then I saw them get into a fight, and it was the funniest thing I'd ever seen.
Ashley. Ashes to ashes. Do you like Bowie, by the way?
I do like Bowie.
I try and mention Bowie every show at some point. He comes up.
Just Bowie is amazing.
He is amazing. What musical artist would you say are totally compatible with your work, or do you use during shoots, or that you really like?
I enjoy some Radiohead.
Yeah.
I definitely enjoy some
Tom York.
That guy.
Yeah.
Yes, he sings.
Roxy Music. You know Roxy Music, Brian Ferry?
No.
I think that would work for you, just because his album covers were similar.
I'm going to check that out.
Yeah. What about The Cure?
I love The Cure. I love this guy, Benji Hughes.
Who?
Benji Hughes. You would love Benji Hughes.
Benji Hughes?
Benji Hughes is, he's incredible. I use a lot of his songs and stuff. And
really?
He is just,
download that, Brad.
He's from another planet. You would love him. He's got a gigantic beard. He's about, what would you say, Jordan? Is he like a deuce and a half? He's probably 200 pounds.
Pushing 3.
You know what I mean? Pushing 3.
It's difficult for enlarged people to make it in the music industry. it can happen. You know, you got, you know, Slim Harpo, maybe Leslie West from
Fat
Mountain.
Fat Joe, Notorious B.I.G.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Lady Gaga.
East Coast. No, she's thinned out.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're thinking of Lady Gogo.
That's right. Sorry.
Lady Gigig.
Yes, yes.
Giga Gaga Gogo. Yes.
New name later says, what about Meatloaf?
Meatloaf lost a lot of weight.
Was he that fat?
He was pretty big.
Did Meatloaf, I mean, he named himself Meatloaf. I mean, if you eat a lot of Meatloaf.
You will.
I hate Meatloaf.
Well, Milli Vanilli.
I like Meatloaf, but I don't like Meatloaf.
Milli Vanilli were huge originally.
Were they?
But then they were replaced with a thinner version.
I used to be a large man.
How large?
I used to be about 400 pounds.
Oh, stop.
Okay, here, I got a question for you. I want you to tell me three things about your upbringing, and have only one be true, but like, just like, and then okay. I'm gonna try and guess that, because I can't have you be all the guests. I gotta play some games.
Okay, okay, so I'll tell you three things and only one of them is true?
Yeah, about you growing up.
Oh, man.
You could do it, I know it.
Oh, yeah. Okay, it's the lies that I gotta worry about.
No,
the truths
no.
are easy.
We know the truth is a lie.
The truth is a lie. Okay.
Hold on, I wanna please my producer.
Are you ready?
Tyler's going to create two mythologies in one reel.
Okay. Ready?
Yes, sir.
The first time I went skydiving, I was 10 years old.
The first time skydiving, 10 years old.
I burned a house down when I was 9.
These are lyrics, by the way.
I know.
I burned a house down when I was 9.
I didn't kiss a girl until I was 16.
I was skydiving when I was 9 into a house of whores. I burnt them all down and ate up their pores. And now I'm in jail, but I don't remember why. So I'll take another plane and go back to the sky. Skydiving. Skydiving. I say skydiving is real.
It is real. Wow. That's impressive.
It's not really.
Well done.
I could see it in your soul.
Yeah.
Your lies are covered with a thin dust that speaks of crimson and mercury. It's a good thing no one in our audience is taking any Okay, we got another one that's going to speak to what you were speaking about, because you rock and roll on this. All right, you ready for this?
Yes.
All right. Let's go back to the Dirty Does, because I want to see one of these cats over here. All right, one of these guys was harassing a black man at a club.
Hopefully it was the black man.
Actually, the man's name was Marlon Baker.
Marlon Baker?
Yeah. And that's
Tennessee?
The name of the guy. A man named Darren Christopher Abbey, I'm going to give you a clue on this, and said, you know, blacks are not welcome in this bar.
Mm.
And so, you know, Marlon said, fuck that, get out of here. So it goes out, and then this individual comes up to him, gives him more stuff, and I mean, Marlon cold cocks him.
It's got to be number 8, because it's, you know, the only guy who looks like he messed with a big black guy.
That's it, number 8. That's the guy, and you know what? That's the guy. You hit it. And the thing that really...
Don't do that.
He's a skinhead, Ku Klux Klan racist, which you were talking about Ku Klux Klan a second ago. Okay? So the thing that really is funny about this is Marlon was wearing a jacket that was from his boxing team. So it was like, day. So next time you hit on a racist...
Can I tell you a trick about fighting people?
Yeah, because I'm not into fighting.
Okay. So if anyone ever comes up to you and they want to fight you...
Mm-hmm.
All you got to do is just get really in close to them.
Yeah.
And take your thumb and you jab them right here. One time, the fight's over. If that person's ears are messed up, if they have like cauliflower ears, run away.
Because it won't make a difference.
Run away because they will beat you senseless.
Well.
They will spank you on the ground like you were a child.
I am a child and I enjoy spanking, but not on the ground.
But not like this.
No, I like to be suspended from 2 nylon tethers. With a pulsing apparatus which somehow emanates violet light.
It took everything in me right there not to spank you.
But you did. It was just really quick.
Yeah.
And I did not enjoy it as much had it been a nanosecond longer. Right. Another song.
Had it been a New York minute.
Do you know how many songs you've written tonight so far?
How many?
6.
Whew.
That's 7.
Banging out the jams.
That's 8.5. Stop it before we go LP.
Charles, your audience is asking, are we going to play Find the Monkey tonight? I got about 9 requests.
All right, well, let's go to it.
Find the Monkey?
Yeah, Find the Monkey. We'll go to it right now. Boom. Give me a Find the Monkey.
Got to give the people what they want.
You got it. And we were ironically going to go, all right, Find the Monkey. This is, once again, a game about the visual acuity. Mm. All right, see that monkey there? Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you an image, and it'll be very quick, and there'll be one monkey in it.
Okay.
Okay, go, boom. I'll take it away then. Well, I think it'll be easy this time. Did you see the monkey?
I mean, I saw what appeared to be a monkey in the bottom, in the middle.
Uh-huh, the bottom in the middle.
Yeah.
Well, perhaps you didn't see the monkey.
I didn't see the monkey.
Good work.
I don't have glasses on. I can't really see anything that far, to be honest.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, this is going to make this game another kind of easy.
Yeah.
Well, what kind of glasses do you use? These are for reading.
Okay. Oh, that doesn't help at all.
No, this is for reading.
Shit.
Okay, well, let's try another one. Try that one again.
Got it.
Okay, you see the monkey?
Yeah.
Okay,
now it's cheating when I can see.
No, you should see.
Okay.
But I find it kind of amusing that a man who makes his living through his eye can't see.
Blind as shit.
It's like such an irony. If somebody gets your glasses and the pictures, you see the pictures? Since he got glasses, this shit, it's like a bottle of Windex.
That's right.
And a nose spray bottle. That's nothing.
That's right.
We're the broads with the blood.
I can see perfectly through the camera.
That's my point.
Yeah.
It is the lens finder.
Uh-huh.
You are the image maker.
Yep.
Interesting. Let's go for another Find the Monkey. Tyler Shields, photographer, artist.
I'm trying.
Okay, and this one, boys and girls at home can play too. That's more complicated.
Well, there was a monkey with something sitting in his lap, third over from the right, second row down.
He got it. Nail it up. Bring it up. Let's see it happen.
Very good, Tyler.
That's it. It's a little monkey and a little funny thing.
See, from here, like here, I literally can't see. And then
you just for the next time on the show, show him another Find a Monkey, because then I got something specially that I had planned for you, mister. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. We'll do that one. Fuck the Find a Monkey. Did you see anything in that one?
I did. I saw Lindsay Lohan in a tunnel.
Aha. Uh-huh. Good eye.
Right in the middle.
Okay, this is called Find the Shielder.
Oh. Can you play this with other people when I'm not here?
I never do.
Amazing.
I will, though, if I have your permission.
Please.
All right, let's show that one again.
Find the shields. I like it.
Shield the finders. Show that one again.
Yes.
See that?
Yes.
Okay, now let's do another one with that same image.
Those are good tones.
Yeah, that's the idea. The idea is I took your images and tried to tone them out.
Yeah.
Do me another one to find the shielder. Blunk.
I missed it. Couldn't see it.
That was the idea.
Yeah.
Let's go again.
There's nothing there.
Anybody at home see it? Anyone in the home audience? Let's try to find the shielder again. Shamanama!
No, bottom left corner, third from the left.
You got it.
Yeah.
That's it. Let's see that one. All right, now let's look at the image, actually, because it's a pretty remarkable image.
Oh, thank you.
That's Lindsay Lohan. And she's in a tunnel. Where's that tunnel?
That's in downtown LA.
Tunnels are great, aren't they?
Yeah, I love them.
It's metaphoric for so many things, would you say?
I would agree with
you. Would you say it's a phallus invertus?
I was going to say the nose, but sure.
The nose?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Maybe the mouth.
The mouth. Interesting.
You know, maybe
once
if you,
again.
When you rip a man's eye out, it kind of looks like that too.
Well, it depends what technique you use.
Right.
I don't rip an eye out.
You go in?
I just let it follow my fingers.
Right.
Retinal attraction.
Right.
But I don't do it because it's bad karma.
I go with the Maltese pinch.
Well, I did that in France. That's what I did to that cop.
That's what you did?
Well, she stole my money. All right, let's do another one, because I like finding
you told me that guy was trying to rape you, and that's why I took you in.
That was...
You lived with me for 6 weeks for free.
You're confusing
and then,
Greece.
And then you pooped on my table that would appear to be some sort of a refrigerator apparatus that I had invented, and then you were gone.
That was not
And
me.
You didn't leave a note or anything.
That was Clark Duvon, and he was wearing a mask. You're so easily fooled. We knew your eyes weren't that good. Duvon,
I've been blind for hundreds of years.
That is why we have another image to sharpen your eyes and to focus your mind. Let's look at another finder. Oh, slap it away. Did you see your image in there?
I did not.
That's because it's all blended, tonality. Let's do it again a little longer this time so the boys and girls at home can see. You saw it then.
No, missed it.
That's even better. I fooled the shielder with his own work.
I nailed it.
Imagine a king not seeing his own concubines. Imagine a man not recognizing his own toes. Or even your own butthole, for crying out loud. You've probably never seen that. I won't play that game, though. It's not for the squeamish.
It's
but
really
no one knows what their asshole looks like.
Everyone said it was the one in the middle.
The middle is correct. Let's look at it, Tyler.
Jenna.
Jenna?
Jenna.
All right, let's see that one big time.
That one.
Great image.
Can I tell you about this image?
I'm hoping. Please.
So she, right here at this moment, was 10 feet deeper into the water. And I was like, and Jordan is in the background holding a lantern, and we're in the pitch black in the middle of the night in the middle of the ocean.
Which ocean? Just, I gotta clarify.
Malibu.
Okay.
And this apparently is where the sewage runs off, so a human being's not supposed to go in there, but whatever. So she's about 10 feet back, and I said, come closer to me, come closer to me, and she couldn't hear me. And the wave literally picked her up, brought her right there to where you can almost see the rocks right there in the front, and plopped her down right there. And she was like, and that's...
I'm not surprised. Because of just the way that you have conjured the elements of my prepared show in your spontaneous reaction, it is though you have pulled all of the images in a wave of consciousness and plopped them right on my white dodecahedron.
I love this thing.
White dodecahedron.
It's a white dough, Pinky Pinky Step.
That was fun, but not
join
for
in
the
sometimes.
Other
Charles, the great Miles Dougal is in the chat room and got very excited because you said butthole.
Butthole?
Well, that explains a little bit more about Miles than most of our listeners and viewers want to acknowledge.
Yeah.
Do you think we have any viewers that aren't listening or any listeners that aren't viewing?
Definitely.
I would think the proportion is less than 3%.
I would say 2.7, 0.8, 0.137.
Once again, 27 is my number. Yeah. 27, 3 to the third power, the reciprocal of the prime number, 27.
Perfect.
37, 27.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic.
You can just nod when he does that.
Me? No, I'm listening.
I'm nodding too.
I'm paying attention.
Not nodding off, I'm nodding on. Notting Hood or Notting Ham?
Notting Ham.
Jews don't eat ham.
They don't.
That's why it's Notting Wood.
I haven't had ham in 20 years.
I haven't had a four-legged animal in about the same time.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It's just because of the gravitational field necessary.
Mm-hmm.
You know, creatures on four legs and land animals. Gravity is more difficult. The musculature is larger.
Right.
Aerial tissue, things that fly,
mm-hmm.
you know, you don't need as much, or aqua tissue.
Right.
So I'll eat a bird or a fish.
Sure.
Got to eat something.
Why not?
It's eating light, basically. We
I
talked
love it.
About it. Can I show you another Tyler image?
Please, yes.
I'd like to see if I can fool you again, mister. Show me something. Oh, look at that.
Oh, yeah.
You see yours in there?
I did see that one.
Okay, let's show that one and then go to the next one, too, because I have three of this
yeah.
one.
Yeah.
All right, it's middle... Second
yep,
next to the yellow.
Right.
Let's see that same image again. Who is that in that image?
That is Shiloh Fernandez.
Shiloh Fernandez.
Fernandez.
With a name like Shiloh Fernandez, there is no picture you cannot find. Show me another Shiloh Fernandez.
Ooh. Bottom.
Bottom, got it. And yep. one more for Shiloh, and then let's see the real one. You can leave that one on for a second just to see the
bottom
meandering.
Again.
Yeah, just to see how,
that's awesome.
How the images kind of congrue
wow.
together.
Wow. Awesome.
And also, for you as the photographer,
yeah.
thinking that's your image, but your image attracted all those other
yeah.
images to it. They're all related to it through tone,
I love
and view,
it.
And shape.
It looks very similar to the honeycomb.
Yeah, and also to the
yeah.
the Buddha.
Yeah.
Now let's look at that actual image, because this is
that's an amazing
this is Shiloh.
Thing.
So I nearly died taking this picture, and so did he.
Well, this is, I'm glad we came to this point
yeah.
in the show to
yeah.
talk about it.
Yeah.
Before we talk about the almost death of T.S. We're going to have a moment of reflection. Where was that taken?
It was taken in Ukiah, California.
What'd you call me?
Ukiah.
You don't call me Ukiah, motherfucker.
I call you whatever I want.
Okay.
Fletcher.
All right, I'm sorry.
It's my universe.
Here, then. You got to do this, then.
Okay.
If it's that going to be, that going to be, here, I'll get it started for you.
Oh.
As you tell me, anytime you talk about death, you must spin this. It prevents any kind of negativity from occurring. All right, tell me about the Ukiah incident.
There I was, sitting with Shiloh in a rental car outside of a logging house. And I said, I think we can break in. I think we can get in there.
Really?
And so we did, but we didn't know if there were going to be guard dogs. But I have an affinity for running from guard dogs, so I was really kind of excited. And then
was the wind kind of sounding like this?
Just like this. I'm pretty sure I saw you in the corner with Brad on a horse.
That was not a horse. It was me wearing a tutu and $5 worth of chicken.
Okay, so We made it inside, and it was too dark to get any shots, but there was one spot that had a light on it. And that spot happened to be about 100 feet in the air. So I had to climb a redwood tree and go out on a branch, while he had to jump over some sort of like a moat or a river. I don't know what was inside the water. So he scaled up to the top of those trees, and I scaled out the branch, and I was hanging over top of him trying to get the picture, and the branch cracked while I was on it.
I am so enthralled that I can hear the timber crackling.
Yes.
I can smell the Ukiah night.
And then when he was climbing down, he fell off the trees into the said water, which we didn't know what was in the water. Could have been tree branches in there. Fell completely inside it, all the way underneath, head to toe, in the water. It was about 5 feet deep. Stopped his fall.
Shiloh went from high to low.
He went high to low.
I want to see the picture again.
Can we see the picture?
I love Shiloh. All right, let's look at the picture again.
So what, you're in the air and half of these things are cut? I mean, what's...
Yeah,
They're in the house, obviously, and where all the timber is.
Right.
You're up top.
Yep.
And you haven't fallen yet.
No, I didn't. I never fell.
But the branch cracked.
The branch did crack, and I thought I was going to fall. I would have fallen directly on him.
And what happened when the cops came, or what happened?
So then we got out of there, and as we were hopping the fence back the other way, I saw a guy with the fuck you tattoo on his head. Maybe it was the same guy. I don't know. Where was that guy from?
He was an authority? I don't think he was.
No, he wasn't an authority.
Maybe it was his father.
Security guard.
Could have been.
Army fellas.
But we made it out of there.
You can't be in here.
I think the guy was more confused as to what we were doing on the wood. And why any idiot would want to take a picture of his lumber.
Would.
It's a great shot.
Anyone.
Thank you.
It's totally
Has that received more accolades than any other shot?
People definitely love that one. I don't know. Are you asking me which one has received the most accolades?
I was asking that. But which one? Yes, which one?
I don't know. It's tough. I mean, that one definitely gets a lot. The X-ray.
Okay, hold on. Let me just show you what my next one is. Because I have selected past the find the chandelier.
Shiloh, where are you?
It's coming. We can bring back Wooski now if we dream slowly.
Oh, yes.
Is that the one you're talking about?
That is the one I'm talking about.
I just want to say, like, that's the next one that I had selected. You know what I'm saying?
Amazing.
It's called Link It and Think It.
I'm putting this down before I take it home with me and do it
it's
forever.
Okay. Well, it's nice, huh?
I love that.
I made this a long time ago.
By the way, he's about the only guy that's been able to spin it with you the whole time. Too.
Well, not only that, he's the only person that knows exactly what we're going to be talking about before and after we say it. But I knew that by looking at his images.
The X-ray.
Yeah.
You want to know about that?
I do, for many reasons.
I got radiation poisoning doing that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Need
so
for it?
That I'm fine now. In and out got me. I'm good. That one, I took an actress to a doctor's office. I didn't tell the doctor that I was bringing a gun, so I tucked the gun in my back of my pants, and then I was like, "Oh, it's gonna be fine. I'm just gonna put my hand in her mouth, and then I want you to do the X-ray." And then when he was like, "Okay, I'm ready," I took a gun out, and he was like, and then I put the gun in her mouth, and there you go.
Wow.
And but we did about 7 or 8 takes, maybe. Yeah, so we did 8 takes of it, and the doctor was like, "You're really only supposed to have 3 X-rays on your head at one time," and we didn't have the lead vest. So she was pretty sick for like a week.
Well, that's when she was sick for. We don't know. Her children may be born with wooden chips.
She also smoked a lot of cigarettes after that, so I don't think that helps.
Are you familiar with Curlian photography?
Curlian?
Yeah.
No.
Have you ever seen a picture of a leaf where part of the leaf has been removed and you see energy emanating from around it? It's called the lost leaf effect.
Yes.
A woman named Thelma Moss, UCLA, used to experiment with that. Mm. And I wanted to try and photograph laughter. Because I know when I'm on stage, I feel something coming.
Right.
So I went into this room similar to that, except the energy was different than X-rays, different part of the electromagnetic spectrum. And I tried to make them laugh, and then do the image, but they overexposed them. So my experiment failed, whereas your picture has become quite iconic, I should say.
Thank you. It worked.
Indeed.
That was trouble.
I think we should jump to patents.
Yeah, I think so too.
We patents? Got to. Yeah, we're going to patents.
I'm ready.
This means that.
I love patents.
Who's choosing before you were born?
Okay.
Oh, can you run Who's Shoes quick?
No, you know, there's not enough time.
It's a good Who's Shoes, Charles.
I'm telling you right now. I mean, Who's Shoes is a whole episode.
Okay.
I mean, you want Who's Shoes? How much? How over do you want to go?
I will come back for shoes.
Do you want me to run Who's Shoes or not?
Yeah, do a quick Who's Shoes, Charles. That's a good one.
All right, we'll do Who's Shoes.
Who's Shoes?
Okay, Who's Shoes?
Who's Shoes? Okay.
Okay, see that?
Yes, I see a chair and a question mark.
Okay, now you're going to tell me Who's Shoes.
Okay. Okay.
You don't know yet.
Lady Gaga.
Incorrect. I'm going to give you a clue.
Okay.
But we need the next picture first. The clue, she danced with the Joker.
Katie Holmes? No.
Only one guest per side.
I mean, come on. How do I not know that? Michelle Pfeiffer.
Nice try. Let's go again.
It's a generational thing there.
Want another clue?
Yes.
You ever read Tom Robbins?
Oh my God. I can't believe you just asked me that.
Why is that?
I've never read Tom Robbins, but I have so many people in my life who keep telling me about this one book.
Jitterbug Perfume?
No. It's the one with the guy named the Outlaw in it.
Another Roadside Attraction?
That's it.
Still Life with the Woodpecker?
There you go.
Okay. All right. Here's your next clue.
I need to kill that guy.
No, I recommend.
You're dead, Tom Robbins.
Jitterbug Perfume.
You're dead.
First. Read Jitterbug Perfume.
I'm not reading any of them. I'm going to kill that guy.
Don't kill him. You go to jail. No more. You can take pictures.
I buy my freedom. I'm rich.
Don't kill him, man.
I buy my freedom. You're dead, Tom Robbins.
You're dead.
I'll kill you.
Don't do that, son.
I got Kim Basinger, Julie Newmar.
All right. In the book, Another Roadside Attraction,
I won't kill him.
An erratic clock kept track of our arguments. It ticked with a Puerto Rican accent. In the clock's ticking, I heard blank, blank, dancing. Andy Warhol went to the auction and purchased blank, blank's old shoes. Blank, blank had extremely tiny feet. Her shoes were about a size one.
Marilyn Monroe.
Nope. Next one.
No idea.
All right. We're almost there.
Ooh, who is this person?
It's a tough one.
It's a toughie.
It's a tough one, but the thing that gives it away
is... it like Ava Gardner?
Her feet were... she was born with deformed kind of feet, and her shoes were enormously small. As a matter of fact, her shoes were big as a minute.
Damn it.
I love themes. Let's bring it up to the next one. I would say more of a burlesque minute.
Who is this broad?
It's crazy to think. I'll give you another clue.
Is she royalty?
Headdress Chiquita Banana.
Well, now you gave it away.
Well, maybe not. Slap it up.
Let's see.
Nicholas Coachman.
Carmen Miranda?
Yeah, that's the girl. Show me the next one so you see a better picture of it.
Wow. It's a good Who's Shoes.
The Who's Shoes is hard to do because, and you're not really supposed to guess it.
Right. No one ever guesses.
No one's going to guess it. It's more about the game itself. Right. And Dance with the Joker? Let's see that. Cesar Romero. And there he is, the Joker. What's
the
funny about that?
Joker.
Look at the mustache. They didn't even have him shave. He just whited it out. Crazy, huh?
That's awesome.
All right, now we're going to jump to Pat's. We're going to have to go over again.
Let's go, Pat's.
We'll go, Pat. Now, tonight we have a special patent deal, too, because normally we just have the mystery patent.
Okay.
Tonight, not only is it a mystery patent, but it's a celebrity that invented it.
Okay.
You ready?
Yes.
Slap it. That's the celebrity patent, which is also the mystery patent. We're going to come back at the end of all the patent run, and we're going to try and figure out who that is. I'll give you three clues.
Hot tub?
Too. All right, let's go. Let's go for the first patent. Because I try and make everything fitting my guess,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
We come back to the mystery patent.
This is not anything to do with camera, but the guy invented his name, MF Camera. Motherfucking camera.
Motherfucking camera.
And what's the year, my brother? 1927. See what I'm saying? This is the next one. It's a camera gun. You know, you like cameras and guns, right?
I love guns.
Check this out. Do you know about this? 1933.
Yeah.
Ever see this?
I have.
For real?
Yep.
No way.
In a dream or in real life?
No, in real life.
Well, let me see if you've seen another camera gun. I got a bunch of them for you, dude. This is just the regular camera now. Look at the name, Jane Grief. Hmm. All right, look at her little camera.
Wow.
Yeah, you should use one of those.
That's crazy.
This is a patent, by the way, United States Patent Office. These are not cheap to get.
Right.
They require money.
Right.
That's why they're not cheap.
She made a smiley face camera.
A little funny camera. Not quite like the gun camera. Let's show them another one. This is a life expectancy timepiece, not a camera, but your work to me has a lot of temporal existence questions. So this is a little watch that you wear.
Wow.
It computes your expected lifespan and tells you how much time you have remaining.
That's amazing. I have this watch in my house and it just says zeros all the way across.
Well, when you go home, my friend,
yeah.
The times, they are changing.
Yeah, I don't believe in time.
I don't believe in space.
Hmm. Well.
Neither. Time was invented so he wouldn't have to do everything at once.
Right.
And space invented so he wouldn't have to do it in the same place.
Right.
Let's look at a photographic gun.
Photographic
from
gun.
From 1988.
Oh, wow.
Is that cool or what?
Wow.
Matt, you should do your shoots with that.
I should.
I mean, that's wacky.
People are
right?
already scared enough of me.
I know, but that was really just like, I put it down. If you go through security.
What are you doing with that gun?
It's just a picture, honey.
All right, let's look at another thing. This is a camera combination.
Okay.
The inventor, too. It's a camera that looks like a little plane.
Like a little plane.
But it never took off. You know why?
Yeah, because it was the Spruce Goose.
Because it wasn't geared.
Hercules?
It had no lift.
It looks like Hercules.
It does. Yeah. Well, you know the Bernoulli principle, right?
No.
Bernoulli principle is what enables planes to fly. Because, you know, the wings are curved, right?
Right, right.
So as the wind is flying over it, it's flattened the bottom, so it goes over the top.
And then
it takes longer, but the bottom it goes quicker.
Right.
And that causes lift.
Right.
That's Bernoulli principle. See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that you have incorporated that in your work, even though you don't know it.
I understand the method of the technique, but yes. I did not know the name.
That is why I brought it up, because I would suspect in the next quadrant of time,
yes,
the name Bernoulli will appear, and then you will find a synchronistic link between this moment and that. May we see the next one, my gentle friends? Posable doll means from movable mounting, same in toy camera. A lot of people. Oh, go give back 1 second because I think it's kind of funny.
What?
The guy's name is Flicker. Flicker and Gay.
Wow. Gay Flicker.
Sweet Road.
Sweet gay flicker.
And then look at the invention.
Sweet gay flicker.
Sweet gay flicker tap.
Wow.
And it's a little toy where you click the camera
that
and then
is
the
weird.
Doll.
That's strange.
That's the point. You know how many? There are over 7
odd.
Million patents and counting. Hmm. And, you know, we know about Edison's light bulb and
right.
Tesla, but there's some things that are out there that are just, they're nuts.
Right.
And that's the part of what FU is about, is showing patents. I have a couple patents for myself.
What do you got? Did you patent the odorless underwear?
I patented the reverse underwear anti-aircraft seat.
Damn.
But it was turned down. Prior art. Someone had already done it.
Sorry.
On a hovercraft. It wouldn't hover. Not too crafty, but too easy enough. All right. That's a good one. Now, this one I picked especially because of you. Because somehow, and this is really going back, I couldn't even find a clean copy of this. But it reminded me, if you lived in those times, this would be what one of your photo shoots would look like.
Amazing.
Isn't that crazy?
That's awesome.
It's a globe, little balloon globe.
That's awesome.
Isn't that beautiful? I just thought, because, you know, you just said you didn't believe in time, right?
Mm-hmm.
So here I go back to 1800s talking about you.
Yeah.
Because time is, you know, it's relative to your distance from gravitational field and how fast you're going.
Right.
So technically, if you go to the top of a tall building and run really fast, time slows down.
That's true.
Wonderful. Could I share another one, please?
Yes.
Thank you. An article of clothing with a novel attachment means. Now, you have any idea what this is going to be? Because I think this is good for some of your models. Because you have hot chicks, by the way, in your shoots.
Thank you.
Now, I do know some people. The elusive Mr. Wyman works with, who prefer corpulent, fubsy kind of women with largeness. I won't mention any names, but...
Are you talking about breasts?
No, I'm just talking about...
Just in general?
Big. No, okay. I'm not even talking about mammaria.
Oh, okay.
I'm just talking about, like, you know...
The mammaries?
Big women.
Just
big,
a,
jumbo
just
juicy.
A big,
all right, let's
big
let's flash to the plash of the cash case and see how we do. There's the little actual patent, and that's the attachment device.
Okay.
It still may not be clear. Now, that would be a garment that would be worn to cover her pubis. And the unique attachment means is to insert that.
Wow.
And that's how you attach it.
Wow.
Crazy, huh?
Wow.
Yeah.
That is awesome.
Attachment. And that's a patent.
It's weird because I invented that. I just didn't know that it existed already.
Well, everything exists at
right.
some point,
yeah.
and that's what the future yeah. does. Now look at this. There's another way of putting it. And look at that, Carmen Miranda.
Wow.
Once again, the web is
it all,
being stitched.
It's all circular.
Only that goes in her ear.
It goes around.
You know, so you don't want to mix those up.
Right, no.
Because you know.
Or maybe you do.
Well, if you're hard of earring.
You know what I mean?
Or herring.
Herring.
Let's flash to another one. This is a personal pelvic viewer.
Oh, sh.
And this is a guy that did this. A personal pelvic viewer. Now, that's elaborate uh-huh. looking stuff.
Right.
Once again, I could see this device, one of your photographs,
yeah.
a model holding this, another
yeah.
one about to receive it. And
so
it,
what does
it's,
that do, actually?
Well, it looks like
you.
A hot dog gone wrong.
If we go to the next little image, I can, it says, a lone human female to conveniently take video images from within her own vagina.
That is just beautiful.
Isn't that nice?
That
See.
Is just beautiful.
Okay, let me
you
just
think, you think we don't prepare for
you, Oh,
Charles.
Man.
Let me
you
tell
know,
you
Charles
something.
Fleischer.
What
I'm telling
it,
everyone I know to come on this show. This shit is amazing.
What makes that really good for me, if we just talked about, you know, right. a pussy cam.
Right.
Or a vaginal cam.
Right, it's no good.
It's no good, but no. it's a government document.
Right.
It gives us credibility. We're not
right.
just being sneaky. Man, get
right.
a vagina cam.
No, my favorite is every single thing that exists, somebody went through a process to make it. These
yeah.
cameras, some dude made these cameras. This mug, somebody made this mug. Somebody at some time was like, this is how we're going to make a mug.
And there was a meeting,
And
too.
It caught on. And there was a meeting about it.
A meeting we shall handle
often,
here.
I often wonder, when I see movies, I often wonder, what was that meeting like?
You don't need
How
to
did that come together?
You don't
you know
need
what
to
I mean?
Wonder.
Let's bring this guy and this guy together. That'll be funny.
You can't have that. I've known people that write screenplays that throw in a scene that they know is going to be taken out.
Right.
Because in the hierarchy of the movie-making decision-makers, somebody is in that chair, and he has to put his two cents in.
Mm-hmm.
He has to say, no. My
right.
job is to say this, no, no. So, you know, you put little pre-played scenes.
And
that
you
know
let
them
take them
out.
Out.
Yeah. The exploding helicopter with the vagina cam.
That's out.
And the backwards underwear.
Right.
Really, we can't have that? Damn. That was going to make
that
the movie.
That was my
right.
favorite scene.
Me too. Well, what can you do?
Oh.
All right, we got another.
That's why they got
cam.
Blu-ray now.
Blu-ray.
I mean.
Blu-ray Charles.
Blu-ray.
That's what his first wife said.
Blue?
She Blu-ray Charles.
She did Blu-ray Charles.
But not all at once, because his underwear was backwards. If I showed you, you'd freak out.
Are you a Hanes man? I take you as a Hanes over Fruit of Loom.
I go more like random.
Random?
Random. Random, but I'm definitely a boxer, though.
Yeah? You yeah. go, okay.
You got to have, you know, a place
yeah.
to dance.
You want the freedom.
I want the ballroom.
You want the freedom, for sure.
I want the freedom, and I want, you know, and plus my father was a boxer man.
Huh.
What about you? Was your dad a boxer man or a jockey man?
He wore military underwear.
My father was in the military.
Yeah?
Yeah. I've showed pictures of my father with his pet monkey.
Really?
Yeah, a monkey named Duchess.
Duchess?
Yeah, because.
Duchess!
Duchess!
Come to me, Duchess!
Duchess not here.
Oh.
She's shot.
You never know.
If you shot down, and you can eat what the monkey eats.
Right.
Yeah, Duchess.
That's genius.
So your mother and father, who slept on the right and who slept on the left side of the bed?
Dad was on the left, mom was on the right.
Interesting. And when you're cohabulating with your
females?
Yeah.
I like to mix it up because I don't like to be compared to either one of them. You know
your
what I'm
parents
saying?
Or the girls you're with?
Anybody.
Nicely done.
Thank you.
Photographs will be available later.
That's right.
No extra charge. All right, let's show another little magical
what
woman here from the FU Patents Skamoodler.
Patents?
This is a collar.
A collar.
Yeah, because once again, I'm Uh-oh. Thinking of things that would be helpful
yeah.
in your shoots.
Please.
And we can go, these, Robin. It's a dog.
I love that they put it on the woman.
It's the same collar.
Oh.
And it says, happy birthday.
Oh.
The same collar. Let's go in there. Yeah.
And I love it that she looks like Betty Draper there.
But what about the fact that is Betty Draper? But
yeah.
they decided, well,
Don, my collar's tight.
Let's just make them dash. You can't have a solid
right.
line.
No.
And that collar only works if you have little dashes.
Right.
If you don't have a solid outline.
What does every proper 1950s woman need?
Dashes.
A dog collar.
A dog
with
collar
dashes.
And dashes.
Yeah.
And a dog to match.
Mm. I put a dog collar on somebody before.
Yep.
Yeah.
Do you ever use a ball gag?
Mm. I have a teddy bear. The only items in my room, right?
Mm-hmm.
The only thing in my room is there's a bed, there's a fan with no blades, two knives, and a teddy bear with a ball gag.
It's funny you say that because I'm a blade with no fans. But I'm not a gay babe. But guess what? Ball gag. Check it out, my brother. Ball gag.
Ball
toy.
Gag.
Hello. Rocket ship the flower.
Boo!
But this is an interesting ball gag because the ball itself is made of candy.
Is it the candy one? Yeah, I've seen this one.
Well, that's actually maybe a.
That one's rough, man. You can't do that one. You can really hurt somebody with that thing.
Because they suck.
And it's expensive.
Yeah, it's expensive. Yeah. What if they're allergic to the candy?
It's the teeth you got to worry
about.
That's
my hard rub.
You ever have to reset someone's jaw?
After a ball gag or just after a ball fight?
Just in general.
I don't believe in TMJ.
TMJ does not exist.
It doesn't, but transcendental meditation for Jehovah's Witnesses.
No, I'd be resetting. I'd be resetting jaws all day.
You can do it.
Mm-hmm.
You can hear it pop. You know, it's just the joint. You ever smoke a jaw? Ever smoke a joint?
No.
Either way, you're going to get something.
That's right. But I will pop some jaws.
Nicely done.
All
Flax
day.
Seed. Let's find another moment
what
of
do we
floop.
Ray this X-ray camera for underground geological exploration.
I just sense that you have a scientific aptitude, and this is just it's just cool looking.
I love that.
So, and you've spoke of X-rays before,
yeah.
And once again, I'm always trying for the web to weave, not necessarily. And here we go again.
Wait! Can you go back on that for a second?
We can do whatever you'd like, man.
Can I see who did that?
J. H. Andrews.
Huh. Interesting.
That's Julie Andrews.
My grandfather, who invented my father. He used to do that. X-ray underground. Yeah, he did that, and he did a lot of he laid a lot of pipe.
I heard your grandmother say, "Not enough."
Yeah, that's right.
But she said it the next. Not enough, Leafy Schleifen.
Yeah.
Where's the camera? Okay, let's.
Nine.
Go. Nine or ten? Maybe ten to your nineties. Look at the combination gun and camera.
Oh, Atkin. Dick.
Yeah, look at that. Now this one's a little more
elaborate. Whoa.
You know, this, so you
What's
shoot somebody,
here?
you got major camera.
Oh,
look at the detail. The next, look at
that. That's
this
amazing.
This is an invention.
That
a lot
is
of wheels.
Amazing. Yeah,
that's
a
crazy.
Lot.
So you shoot somebody, you got film.
Yeah.
Film at 11.
Amazing.
And this guy's thinking, we gotta have. Look, when I shoot something, I want to see it.
Yeah.
I want to see something die.
Yeah.
What I'm gonna do?
I'm gonna put a camera down.
Camera.
There.
Now I'm going. It's not gonna be just a simple camera.
No.
I'm gonna have lots of little wheels.
I want the most complex camera.
Most complex that a gun will hold. Bam! I got, and then I'll watch it later.
Yeah.
Save bullets.
That's good.
That's nice.
See, because with that you can do the just shoot around like around the corner wherever you need to go, and then you can look at it later.
You could play the film backwards to see something undie.
Yes.
But in life,
I do that often.
Time's arrow is always moving forward.
Right.
But hypothetically, we could invent a reverse entropy universe.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe when this universe reaches some point, it will reverse entropize itself and be whoop, which means we will be here doing this show backwards sometime from now. Let's go for another one because we're definitely going over. This is a large picture camera.
Mm-mm.
Large.
Oh, Warner?
Look how big that is.
This is invented by Warner.
Warner Schleifen. Okay, that's not even the whole deal.
Whoa.
Look how big the camera. See the person there on the left? That's
Whoa.
A large camera.
Oh, man.
That's can you imagine the film on that, man? Well, we need to take another one.
I'm switching to that
8 miles
eventually.
By 10 miles. I think you should do something like
that. Yeah, when I get older, I'm going to switch to that.
But use a large camera and use it to take pictures of stamps.
Yeah.
Nice.
Tiny things, big camera.
Parts of stamps.
Yeah.
Let's look at another one because we're getting close. How
nature.
About a miniature camera? Because, you know, you have to have the wild.
Oh, right. If you got to have the big one, you got to have the small one.
Theobald from Somerville. Look at the size of a quarter.
Wow.
I guess that's a quarter. George Washington. And then it's mounted on that little creature, which doesn't look like it would really
Larry?
Work.
Larry?
Who is that? You know that guy?
That's Larry. That guy's my neighbor.
I know him as Lou.
He's a liar.
He's a lying Larry Luler.
He owes me $11 and he stole my,
Your hat.
No, the thing that you
look like a hat.
You know what I'm talking about? The weed whacker.
Oh, well, I almost put that in the show. Let's look at the next one because that thing is the size of a quarter.
Wow.
That means this guy has a small head and no facial features.
No, that's a Ken doll.
Kendall?
Kendall.
Almost did a thing on David Kendall and Robert Ken Doyle. Let's go to another figure because the patents are getting. Now, I just threw this in because it seemed like it would.
Peanut butter. Peanut butter batter.
Say it faster.
Peanut butter batter. Peanut butter batter.
Peanut butter batter. Pancake mix. Peanut butter batter. Pancake mix. You get your heroin to get your fix, but I get mine from peanut butter batter. Pancake mix.
I just had peanut butter for the first time in my life recently.
Seriously?
I did.
A lot of people are allergic.
What'd you think?
A girl took a picture of it.
Are you eating it? How do you avoid peanut butter?
I avoid a lot of things.
Yeah, but peanut butter. In England, peanut butter and jelly is abhorrent. And you say, what are you doing? Peanut butter and jam, it's disgusting.
Right.
I do, but you know.
I never did it.
It's
and then I did it.
What about cashew butter?
No, God, no.
Almond butter?
No. I've had butter.
Butter, butter. What about, I can't believe it's not butter.
I've had that too.
I can't believe
I'm from the South.
I can't believe
that
it's not
butter. That shit rains
butter.
Like it's king.
I can't believe it's not rain.
You know what I mean?
I can't believe it's not the South.
I can't believe it.
I just named it. There was a big meeting about that. What should we call it? How about like super butter?
Right,
crazy
super
butter. How about, I can't believe it's not, what'd you say? I said, I can't believe it's not butter. That's it.
Sold.
Raggedy.
I want to know where that guy's at right now, the guy who invented the name, I can't believe it's not butter.
Well,
I bet he's in a mansion velcroed to a wall.
I think he's just velcroed to a wall.
Okay.
You know, the guy that whose idea was it to bottle Coca-Cola. It was just sold in, you know.
Right in this.
In the syrup in the bar, and like a little counter things, right?
Fountain soda.
And some guy soda says, fountain. Hey, bottle it. Boom.
Bottled.
Oh, the rest of his life, he's trying to come up with something else.
And he never will. He's
never
dead
will.
Now.
Like, oh, what about the guy? When you're shopping, put down something to divide the groceries from the next person. Huh?
Oof.
Divide them. We could sell ads on it.
Wow.
And we could, like, you know, make a camera out of it.
Right.
Do all right, let's move ahead.
R.J. Perry. Uh-oh.
Yeah. Perry, 1926. Check this out. It's perverse. See that little thing? You touch the camera, this little snake pops out and actually pricks your skin. It punctures your skin. To play a practical joke, persuade to take his own picture, and then a mechanism released which will throw upward devices which have a puncturing point.
Trick camera.
A puncturing point.
Mechanism will be released.
Can you believe that's a toy?
Wow.
And there's another, the same camera, in case you want to, you're not satisfied just with puncturing the guy once, you can puncture him again.
Hit him again, yeah.
Yeah, it's like, honey, I got the greatest damn invention. It's a toy camera, and it picks you, and then does it again.
Somebody spent money to make that. They developed a prototype. They made the whole thing. They had the patent.
The patent.
This is going to catch on, honey.
Big. And in a perfect world someplace, everybody's on, hostess, ow!
There's a warehouse full of those somewhere, probably in Reseda.
They moved it.
Okay.
To Yakima.
Is it behind us?
Everything's behind us.
In space.
If we're not looking forward. Let's find another one because we're moving to the oral condom for preventing sexually transmitted diseases.
Oral
and look
condom.
At the name. Go flash
the Ocon? Is that what?
Who did it?
Paula, oh man.
Bloodsaw.
Paula A. Bloodsaw.
Bloodsaw.
Paula A. Bloodsaw.
Paula A. Bloodsaw saw a blood bud ball. Okay, there it is. It looks kind of like a mask that I would see in one of your photos.
It does.
And there you can see how it's utilized.
It's weird.
It's way weird. And there you put that on, and that allows you to perform, to be a cunning lingus without any chance of a transmitted disease.
Wow.
I guess being humiliated. Isn't really part of the question. I don't want a disease. Humiliation, you know, what's more romantic? Honey, just a second, I want to put on the mask.
Right.
I'm ready. It's like a jelly.
What happens?
I'm ready. Mama.
I like to live my life at any moment with three things. One,
three.
That I could die. Two, that a bear would attack. And three, that a fire may just spring at any moment.
But they're all positive things.
I know. I love all those things.
Why
so
don't you
what I'm saying is,
negativity?
If a bear attacked and you had that thing on, the bear would just laugh at you until it died.
It may prevent the attack.
The bear would laugh itself to death.
And then you would have the fire to
cook. Look at this guy!
The fire would cook the bear.
Right.
You'd eat bear meat,
mm-hmm.
but you couldn't bear it because of the earth sign of the Taurus reversal.
I am a Taurus.
I was suspecting I'd have one for you too, sir.
Mm.
Charles, the fans want to know what the mystery patent is.
Well, let's fucking go to it.
Let their dying.
See what I'm saying?
Celebrity
that?
Patent.
See
David
how
Bain,
everything's
Chris
working
Angel.
Tonight, Brent?
Amazing.
Flowing. All right. There's a celebrity patent. Now, those are the people you get to choose from.
So one of these three people actually patent this device.
See how he puts things into order? That's correct. Now, before you decide on those, let's look at the mystery aspect of this
what
patent.
What is it? Yes.
This is going to what is it? Is it
a
hydrotherapeutic stimulator,
okay.
theatrical illusion, or device and method to produce reflective floating image?
Mm.
And all three, I might mention, were magicians.
That's true.
Well, Brad Wyman doesn't just produce.
Yep.
He reduces subjective objectivity to a finite form of space dust. Back to
That's
the beginning.
That's why I get the big bucks.
All right, here we go. There it is, my friend. We can hear what the viewers out there.
David Blaine device to produce floating image.
All right, that we're getting one on that. So that would be what you call a 1C.
Yeah, and then I've got a 3C from Glancy, which is Gillette and
device. All right, let's defer to the controllers and that my esteemed guest just hazard a monkey on this.
I would eliminate pen. Because I've never seen or heard of him doing anything with water. I don't know if he's ever taken a shower. Chris Angel, again, never seen him really take a shower.
He bathes.
Does he bathe?
I would suspect.
He's a bather?
I'd say he's a
guy lives in a hotel. You know what I mean?
But it's the Luxor.
I imagine a lot of Axe body spray.
I'm going to give you a hint. Go with Mr.
Hold on! Go with no hints!
Try to figure out the patent first.
Yeah, what is the patent?
Well, it's A, B, or C.
A, B, or C.
Then you will be able to figure out who the person is.
Hydrotherapy simulator.
My guest is about to decide.
Yes.
Whether it's the patent, A, B, or C, or the celebrity, 1, 2, or 3. You can choose whichever one you want first.
I'm gonna go with 3.
3.
And I'm gonna go with A.
3A. Pen Gillette, the hydrotherapeutic simulator. Let's look at the real patent, ladies and gentlemen. The hydrotherapeutic simulator. Pen Gillette, we have a winner.
Yes!
Scores again. We do not play games on FU when the vision is true. Tyler did not fail us this time. There it is. And what it does, she sits in the tub, and there's a little squirty-wordy that squirts the water right near her little haunted hood.
Yep.
Boom, boom, boom.
Bam.
Slap the motion flower.
I got that one.
Well, I'm going to stand up because I'm going to move over here.
Like a champ.
And we have, follow me, Glass Oleos.
Oh, okay.
And you can stand if you wish because I have, this is a kind of a synopsis element.
What's happening here?
The show seems to be over.
What? Really?
At least the first part.
Oh, okay.
That's what we've done. We had backwards underwear, floating dust. You know we had some fun.
Tons of fun.
Radiohead and a fat guy with a beard.
With a beard.
I don't remember his name, but you'll tell me, make it clear.
Benji Hughes.
Benji Hughes had the news, but we'll find a point of view. You can look into vaginas with a camera if you want. But be careful of burning bears.
It's true.
We're live this time, you know it's true. Something happened to the point of view.
The porno view?
Thanks to Tyler for joining me this day.
Thank you. I look forward to you in my dream tonight, riding a pink elephant, wearing a sailor hat.
How do you know this isn't the dream that you'll have? But it's not a sailor hat. It's an army helmet.
Okay.
And that's no pink elephant. That's an armadillo with a willing understanding of the future of time. There is no time for you, you know.
No time. No time. Except for the only time that matters to me is what time In and Out closes. 1:30.
In and out. Out and in. We have finished, so we will
begin.
That's it! We hit the show! I want to thank everybody for show number 30, Tyler Sheen!
Yes!
I want to thank my audience, I want to thank my producer, Brad Wyman, my soundman, Otto Schlotter!
That guy, too.
Everybody, what? Come and buy the
what? What?
Don't
what?
Be afraid!
Ah.
No, you can't pick me up
with
a backpack!
Yeah.
It'll hurt you!
Ah.
Just dance! Everybody knows, check out Tyler Shield on his website. He has artwork all over the world. He's a visionary. Great show to Clapton. Everybody knows this show is live, not taped or even artificial.
We'll be back next week, Tuesdays at 8 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time.